Have you ever been in a situation where your database queries are slow and you need to speed them up while keeping costs down? I'd like you to imagine for a moment you've built a movie streaming platform that is growing quickly. When you started, you decided to use MongoDB to store and retrieve movies. This worked really well for a while, and now things are starting to break down. You've already attempted to optimize your queries to MongoDB, and you were able to squeak out a little more performance, but it wasn't enough. You know you need to cache your queries in Redis, but you want to make sure you keep costs down. This is where the cache-aside pattern comes in handy. The goal of the cache-aside pattern is to set up optimal caching for data retrieval on demand. So rather than syncing your entire database with Redis from the start, you'll fill Redis as your data is requested. When an application requests data, you first see if that data exists in Redis. If it exists, you can quickly return it. If it doesn't exist, you fetch the data from your database and store it in Redis for future requests. Then, return the data to the application. Let's see how you might implement the cache-aside pattern in code. Here, I'm using Node.js with the MongoDB client and the RedisOM library. First, I'll create a function to create a hash key based on the search criteria. This will be used to store and retrieve keys from Redis. Next, I'll create a function to find the top movies. In it, I'll get my Mongo and Redis connections. Then create my search criteria. For now, I'm looking for movies in English that have an IMDb rating greater than or equal to 8.5. Now I need to get the hash key to use to search Redis. If I find a value in Redis, then I log the cache hit and return the value. If I don't find the value in Redis, I log a cache miss and then search MongoDB for the movies. Finally, I store the results from MongoDB in Redis, making sure to expire them after 30 seconds, and return the results. Let's run this function twice to see if we get the expected result. When I run the script, you can see I first get a cache miss, then a subsequent cache hit. This is the expected result since we started with nothing in our Redis database. In Redis Insight, you'll see our stored string with the expiration date. When I click the value, you can see the stringified result for MongoDB. Even though this is a string, I can inform Redis Insight that I'm looking at JSON, and it will display it in a format that is easier to read. If you plan to use the cache-aside pattern and store your queries in Redis as strings, one thing you'll need to decide on your own is how frequently you want to expire the data. You don't want the expiration time to be too short, but if it's too long, it can lead to data consistency problems. One way to solve the data consistency issue is to use another pattern called the write-behind or write-through pattern. This is something that I will discuss in a future video. However, another way to mitigate some of the data consistency issues is to get more granular with how you store and retrieve data from Redis. With Redis Stack, you can store and search JSON documents in Redis. So we can rewrite our code to store and search Redis just like we do with MongoDB. Let's look at what that might look like. Here, I'm using Node.js like before, only this time I'm creating a movie collection in Redis using RedisOM. Each movie will have the same fields that I'm storing in MongoDB. To find the top movies, I first get my MongoDB and Redis connections. Then I get the Redis movie repository. Next, I search the repository for movies in English with an IMDb rating greater than or equal to 8.5. The result will always be an array, so for my purposes, I'm comfortable saying that if the array is not empty, then it's a cache hit. Otherwise, it's a cache miss. For cache misses, I get the results from MongoDB. Then I iterate over the results and store each value in Redis. You see here that I didn't set an expiration on my data. For this to work, you'll need to determine the best time to delete the data from the cache. Typically, what people do is delete the data in Redis whenever they delete or update it in MongoDB. Let's run the find top movies function twice and see if we get the expected results. When I run the script, I first get a cache miss, then a subsequent cache hit. This is expected since we started with nothing in our Redis database. Looking at our data in Redis Insight, you can see we now have a collection of movie JSON documents, instead of before where we only had a single key with a string value. Note that there is no expiration on the movie documents. This is because our application will take care of deleting and updating these documents whenever they change in MongoDB. If I click on a movie document, you can see that it is storing all of the movie information that we defined in our schema. Remember, the cache aside pattern is useful when you need to query data frequently and want to fill your cache on demand to save on cost. If you're interested in learning more about storing and searching master data in Redis, check out our ebook that covers 3 design patterns to speed up MERN applications. The link is in the description down below.